to help community City Hall for events and celebrations, and that's why we're here tonight to honor Isaka Shamsud-Din.
Yeah, yeah.
So one of the reasons why we do celebrations, thank you so much, as well as honoring our elders and our unsung heroes and people that should get acknowledged, is really oftentimes people, when they first come on City Hall, their first experience at City Hall is that they're very angry about something. Deservedly so, absolutely, totally get it. But I think if you build in more opportunities for people to come in, when you can celebrate and ask good questions and figure out how do you become a council member, how do you get on a committee, I think you get better civic engagement that way. And this is really why we are helping community use this building to bring folks in. So if you don't want to, you don't have to, but how many people are here for the first time tonight to City Hall? There you go. So a few of you. And you know, the backdrop is beautiful. It's your City Hall. And again, I hope to see you back here for many of those events that we have. So a few months ago, I got kind of a surprising call and a voicemail that said, hey, my name is Isaka, and I'd love to have you out to my studio and show you around. And I was so honored to be called from this icon of Portland's artistic community. And I went out and, oh my goodness gracious, the studio is so incredible. It's history, it's images and sketches from pieces that are halfway done or pieces that were done before. And I just was so awe-inspired by everything around it. It wasn't only that Isaka is such an incredibly talented artist, it was that he centers Black experience and Black families so heavily in history that it was really important to acknowledge him in this way. So I worked with Teresa and Tiffany and Amy and others to create a proclamation for Isaka. And good segue, we actually have a former mayor, Potter, Tom Potter here, who will be reading a proclamation. I have copies too for people.
Thank you, Pauline. Happy June. Hope that you've had a good day. Hope that you've given a few thoughts to what that celebration is all about. We have a 4th of July, and this is, in many respects, an African American birthday. So, please think about that. Think what it means, where we are today, what it means to that. I was called by Pollyanne. She said, would you read the proclamation? I said, I would be honored to read the proclamation. I've known this man. I've seen his work. He's come to City Council when I was in there, brought young people so they could see what City Hall was like. And I've grown to respect him. I had one of his kindlers at home. I forgot to bring with me some of the autograph. But I'll have to take it over to the studio. But this morning, Portland City Council read this proclamation I'm going to read, and the honor. And that's what this is about today. So, without any further, I would like to read it. Now, proclamation is kind of a strange creation. Things sound kind of strange because politicians
design it. Oh, he didn't write it, I did.
Well, I know, but the whereas is what I'm talking about. It looks like a lead of but I hope you wrote it.
I did.
He was declared a child prodigy at an early age and won a scholarship to the Portland Art Museum. This was the beginning of decades of amazing educational experiences using art to build a global consciousness towards social change. Whereas Black families that located in Vanport and became displaced by the flood continued continue to experience racism in Portland and have historically experienced intergenerational displacement and discrimination. Art has always been a bridge for influencing systemic racism for policy change. Civic engagement during the civil rights era attracted the young artist. Isaka Shamsud-Din, as he left Portland for the South to become a member of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, organizing in Arkansas for years before heading back to the West Coast to San Francisco, where he later supported movements using his artistic platforms, the Black Artist Repertory Theater, and as a Black actor. Even before the floods and the 1960s civil rights work, Black arts in Portland was a thriving force for civil rights and social change. Whereas the stories told by Isaka's using art, theater, and music to enhance and created a signature value representing the life, families, work, and culture shared by original descendants of Black Portland. This is an important element that is not always acknowledged when telling the stories of Portland Black history, except by the medium of art. Whereas today on this and everyone thereafter, June 19th, or Juneteenth, is promoted in Black communities across this country as acknowledgement to celebrate the emancipation of all Black Americans. It is emancipation and freedom of expression that will receive these gifts in the artistic genius of Isaka Shamsud-Din, accompanied by his notes and liberated archives. His perspectives on the courage of Juneteenth is cemented in Oregon, on walls throughout the city, on our streets, and even in our parks and transit ways. It's because of the contributions from Isaka Shamsud-Din that we have the intentional access of his experiences in Black education. Isaka has now shared his gift with us, a collection of his work, including the piece made at the former Albina Art Center, which has inspired the limited edition Juneteenth calendar. A legacy project presented and supported by the Arlington Foundation and his many friends. Today, all Portlanders are encouraged to tell stories of social change using literature, photos, and art. We are encouraged to reflect on the spirit and motivation of all Black people in the fight for human rights and dignity. Now, therefore, I, Ted Wheeler, Mayor of the City of Portland, the City of Moses, reading the record this proclamation for the Isaka Shamsud-Din Day, June 19, 2019, and every June 19 moving forward. We encourage all residents to acknowledge and research your local history and the arts, literature, and your family's archives. Today, we honor Juneteenth and Isaka Shamsud-Din.
Day, y'all.